Hi everyone, I'm Sahluko, a lead pastor at Discovery Church. That has kept us, was trainer, that's why you are able to move on your screen today. Kept you alive, protector. That means he cares about you. Sometimes when you come across ama videos like this, we are feeling atenyashunyayezwa, and then these people are not realistic. They are speaking is in daying a pesul wamakanda etu. But I just want to be simple today. I just want to be simple in kulumega nyenawe, understand where I'm coming from, and understand what unkulunkulu ufisani ngempilo yakho. So I want to share a few stories that it's found in the Bible. Remember that the Bible it's also is unkulunkulu, but also it is a history book. So one of the stories that we find in the Bible, Peter, he had an issue. He had a problem, personal problems. He had the issue of finances. And we're in a timeline, before a certain time. So he had a due date and things were tough. And what we're about to do with your muzwake. And then he had a pressure like any man. About my family. But little by little, on that night, Peter went out with his brothers, and then they went with Bahama by official. And Peter is not just an ordinary guy. Peter is an expert when it comes to fishing. It's his business. It's what he knows. He's been trained how to fish. He knows when to fish. He knows the right times. He knows how to fish food on those particular times. But little by little, on this day, they went at night. They try to fish with his brothers and friends. Little by little, but fish they couldn't catch anything. Little was worse. Saying by the time in the morning, while they were packing, giving up. Lost hope, but born with it's finished. And Peter, we had all personal. It was not sensitive as him because he was about to lose the family, he was about to lose the house, he was about to lose certain things. So it became more personal. We didn't make it, we didn't catch any fish. But it's fine, we've lost, we're going to try for another day. But Peter, it was a due date for that day. Little Bible, while they were washing their nets, and then Jesus, there was a man called Jesus, one of the greatest leaders that ever lived. He was preaching to people, he was communicating to people, and because Jesus remember ukuthi uNkulunkulu uqobo and futhi wayeyomuntu uqobo. But little Bible, on that day, ekhuluma nabo, he saw Peter bewasha manet. He saw people that are discouraged. He saw people that are losing hope. He saw people that asebelahle yonke into because impilo zabo kunzima. And uJesu wayesebolega something from Peter. What akungiboleka isikebhe sakho ukuze ame kusona bese yashumayela. Little Bible, what mayema kuleso sikebhe washumayela waqeda ukukhuluma nabantu, and then he went back to address a personal issue. Because what you need to know and understand about our God, God is very personal. So he knows your issues that you deal with them on daily basis. Sometimes you can take it, it's a collective thing. My little Bible, God loved the world. But actually he loved you personally. God had an interest in you. But he was very personal to address one issue to a specific person who's got a pressure on my issues. Peter. So then Peter won't bother escape. Washumaya lama ikreta. Why is he able to attend to Peter? What Peter? Aupindu faga manet. What Peter? Based on my experience, based on my expertise, based on what I know. So let me show you, it doesn't make sense and it's not gonna work. But I love what Peter has done. Esekushilo konke lokho esebile nawo ama doubt waveza into ezipractical njengoba nawo usho ukuthi washonelwa abazali umncane, njengoba usho ukuthi I've lost job, njengoba usho ukuthi pandemic shut down my business. Njengoba usho ukuthi we're looting, we've lost everything. So kunezinto oyibalayo as a practical and irrelevant and asingeke sidinaye ukuthi ngempela ngempela then those things has took place in your life. UPeter why addressa nayo lezi zinto lezo, waveza ukuthi ngifundile, I know this, njengoba nawe ungasho ukuthi I've got a diploma, I've got a master's, but angazi ngiwuthole umsebenzi, I'm not getting the right job, things are not happening the way engiplane ngayo. So everyone on a disappointment in life, but lithi iBhayibheli uPeter wayesethi yena, kodwa ngezwi lakho ngizoqhubeka ngikwenze. I love that statement. That what changed everything. Ukuthi he gave someone a chance. I know that you've been trying on your own. I know that you've been trying with your own abilities, with your own thinking. But I think it's time to let it go. I think it's time to allow someone to intervene in your situation. So on this case, God is willing to intervene in your situation. And uNkulunkulu is ready to come in to be pressure ohlangabezane nayo. Lithi iBhayibheli ke then wavuma uPeter wawafaka amanethi phansi. Lithi iBhayibheli wathi mangabe wafaka amanethi, then wabamba more. Lithi iBhayibheli wabamba kwisikebhe sakhe bazibabiza nabanye. I want to tell you that God is about to do something great in your life. If you allow him to intervene in your life, he's about to do something supernatural. Azoshintsha ngayo izimo empilweni yakho and ashintshe the entire history of your life. UPeter on that day, wathi mangabe labo fishi ababathathayo, ikwamenza waba able to settle all the debts that he had. Kwaba waba able to make sure ukuthi impilo goes back to normal. I want to tell you that there is a miracle. There is a miracle that God wants to do in your life. There is a miracle that God is about to do in your life. But I just want you to give him a chance. I think it's time and say, Lord, I'm giving you a chance. I've tried on my own. I've prayed. I've tried to build this marriage. I've tried to build this relationship. I've tried to build this business, but I've failed. Now I'm dedicating everything unto you, God. So I'm giving my life to you. I'm giving everything that I have to you. And then uNkulunkulu uzoqala enze umehluko kuwe. Yashintsha impilo kaPeter. His business was rescued. It was rescued. His life was rescued. The family nayo was rescued. So everything yasina. So kanjalo nawe, I think you should give this man a chance. I think you should give Jesus a chance. So if uke wamnikeza ithuba, and then you'll begin to see ama changes in your life. So njengamanje, I just want to invite you. I just want you to come. I just want you to come and give Jesus a chance in your life and see ubone ukuthi ngeke nube khona umehluko. Imiracle eyenzeka uPeter isaqhubeka namanje isenzeka. Ayigcinanga kuyena, yenzeka nakuthina. Even in my life, I'm a personal experience to know when God comes in uma ngabe izinto zenzima. So and that's why ukuthi I'm confident ukuthi nakuwena uNkulunkulu angakusiza. I want you to take this opportunity by making sure that you accept Jesus. You come to Jesus just to give him a chance. You've tried everything, why don't you try this one? And then you will begin to see a chance. I want you to, it's a very simple thing. It's a very simple process. You just say, Jesus, come into my life. I want you to take control of my situation. And then you will begin to see. And uNkulunkulu enza umsebenzi. Sometimes we are worried to see Jotif Nikasenza ama prayers amakhulu. Sometimes she pray yakhe ngabancane ibuke ngathi insignificant. But I want to tell you that it will make a greatest change. You just need to say, God, I'm letting everything unto you. And then you will begin to see the change. uNkulunkulu akubusise as you make that decision. I'm so excited. I'm so waiting for your testimony. I'm so eager to know ukuthi uNkulunkulu yini ayishintshile kuwena ekade kufanele ngayo khona. See you when you come and share your testimony.